Welcome to another episode of Behind the Science on Location. I'm your host, Jennifer Fournier. Have you ever wondered how do they make these columns and what goes into the synthesis of the powders that make my separation so powerful? Well, I am curious, so let's take a trip to our Taunton, Massachusetts manufacturing plant to see exactly what is packed in these steel tubes that are at the heart of every liquid chromatography separation. So I'm here in Taunton at one of our manufacturing sites, and I'm excited about what I'm going to learn today. Let's go check it out.
Jen.
Hi, Chris. Just the person I was looking for. So I've been to Taunton in the past. However, I was wondering if you could give me a little bit more details about what we do here.
Sure. In Taunton, we make all the chromatographic media for Waters Corporation.
Wow, yes, I saw on the wall here, and I recognize some of my old friends like Oasis.
Yeah, we actually make a lot of particles here. Mm-hmm. We manufacture about 600 different part numbers. About 300 of those end up in columns that a customer would end up buying.
Wow, so is that unique, or do all column manufacturers do that in-house?
Well, many of our competition actually purchase silica and then process it to get to the bonded level. We're here in Taunton, we actually manufacture the product from scratch. We make the silica, then we build it all the way up through the bonded level, and that way we can control the full quality chain throughout.
So what type of products do we make here?
We make a lot of different products. We have a little wall over here, a little history wall, shows all of our brands. You want to come see it?
Yeah, that'd be great.
All right. So Jen, it all started in 1964 with our brand Styrogel, which we still make in the plant today. And as the years progressed, we made more and more brands. Like in 1994, we introduced Symmetry products. Oasis brand came out in 1996 with sample prep devices. Acuity came out in 2004, which is the biggest brand we make in the plant. And then many more after that.
Wow, Chris, these are a lot of different products here. I would imagine that that would equal a lot of quality control.
Oh yes, quality control is very important. To tell you more about that, we have to go see Dr. Ed Grover though. So let's go see Dr. Ed.
Let's go. Hi Ed, Chris told me that I could find you up here.
Where is Chris, by the way?
Oh, he sent me up here. He had a lot of work to do, but he told me you are the best person to talk to when it comes to looking at all of the way we control the process when it comes to particle synthesis.
Darn tootin' I am the person. He's right for a change. Now, let me take you through the steps, and again, Waters is the only company that does all the chromatographic manufacturing and testing A through Z. So what you see here, Jen, is an overview of our manufacturing process, the white powder, which goes in the columns used by our customer, and these two rows are our QC testing. The most important row is the chromatographic batch test, because that is how our customers use this product that's in the column.
Wow, these are a lot of tests, Ed. I would imagine there's a good amount of people that go into doing all of this work.
Darn tootin', you're exactly correct. So why don't we meet the men and women who make it all happen?
Sounds great, let's go.
Let's go. Bob, how are you?
Good, Ed, how you doing?
Bob, this is Jen Fournier. Jen, this is Bob DiLoretto.
Nice to meet
the chemical engineering manager.
Fabulous, thank you for having us.
Sure.
So I'm learning about all the chemical processes from A to Z, and this is my first stop. Can you tell me a little bit more about how we start this process?
Sure, well this is where we make our fresh made particle.
Okay.
So what we do is we take water and we add an oil-based compound and we mix it together in a tank.
Okay.
And then we pump it around in a recirculation loop, which basically creates an emulsion, very similar to how you make a salad vinaigrette. As we make this emulsion, we form small little spherical particles, and we check the size of those particles.
Okay.
Once the size of the particles are in our specification, then we add another chemical which coats that spherical particle, and we make it, basically transfers it into a solid material, which becomes our fresh-made particle. At that point, we filter this slurry, and we recover the solids, and then they get dried in an oven, and then they await the next step in our process.
Wow, that's fascinating. So what is the next process?
Well, what we're going to do is take you to the very end of the particle manufacturing. We're talking about the coating of the particle, and let's talk to Kyle.
Sounds good. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Bob.
Let's go.
Hey, Kyle, come on over. You know Jen.
Hey, Jen.
Kyle, great to see you.
You too.
Hey, how you doing, Kyle? Long time no see.
So what brings you out here?
So we were just downstairs with Bob learning about how to make a particle. And so we have a fresh new particle, and we were wondering what was next.
Sure. So if you were down with Bob, you saw our fresh-made synthesis. There's quite a few other steps in between, but what goes on up here is our final acid treatment and bonding steps. We actually have one running in this reactor right here.
All right, so once the particle is bonded, what happens next?
Then goes the column packing.
Okay.
To be packed, and it sounds like we should be visiting Tom Grady, the manager of the column packing area. So let's go.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Thank you.
Thank you, Kyle. Hey, Red, how you doing?
Oh, hi, Ed.
How you know good Jen, don't you, Red?
Hi, Jen, good to see you.
Thanks for having us.
Oh, glad to be here.
So it looks pretty busy down here. I understand that all the column packing that's done in Taunton is done in this lab.
Yeah, we support column, all the column packing support comes from this lab here for Taunton. We support the bulk synthesis area.
Okay.
We support Dr. Gu's area for the tech support chemistry. We support new products. And we also help if there's questions with customers. We'll help solve those issues as well.
Great, it sounds like you do a lot of work. Where does it go after it comes in here?
Oh, to the QC lab.
Well, it sounds like we know where we're going next, Ed.
Darn tootin' to the QC laboratory. Let's go.
Let's go.
Nice seeing you.
Chris, how are you?
Hey, Ed.
Jen, this is Chris Paz, the Taunton QC Laboratory Manager, and this is Jen Fournier.
Hey, Jen.
Hi, Chris. So we're in a quality control laboratory, so I'm assuming that you do some QC work here.
Absolutely. Over here is a very complex place. We test from raw materials to our in-process as well as to our finished product, making sure that our LC passes our specification. It's a very complex testing.
I would imagine. Well, it was nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you as well.
Who else are we going to meet now? Waters Corporation is the only company that manufactures chromatographic media from A to Z. Our manufacturing strategy is global, and we will take you through that during the season. The only way to get supreme repeatability and reliability is to control the process as much as you can. If you want to learn more about what we talked about today, go to the link below, and join us next time for another episode of Behind the Science on Location.